Hey everyone, Pastor Steve here. Hope you're having a blessed day, and hopefully we can contribute to that a bit through God's word here in Hebrews chapter 4. In our series we're calling Rest Upon the Rock. And so today in Hebrews chapter 4, as we continue really the theme of the book of Hebrews, which is the supremacy of Christ, in chapter 4, the author begins to elaborate on the supremacy of Christ over the Sabbath. Really, that Christ is our Sabbath, our rest, right? The Sabbath representing that day of rest that they were to take in the times of the law to take a day off of to worship and to just really rest. And of course, because of many of the rules that the leaders put around what it means to rest, it made it difficult to rest because of all the work associated with it. And the author here is encouraging us that in Christ it's not so. Right, in Christ, you and I can truly have a rest for our souls, like Jesus himself, in fact, discusses in Matthew chapter 11, starting in verse 28. A rest for our souls. And when we talk about resting on the rock, that's really the kind of rest that we're talking about. It's not just a physical rest, as important as that is, certainly at times. We can't always dictate that, though, can we? We just came through a week here, you know, after the derecho here in Iowa. A lot of wind and damage, and recovering from that can be a lot of work. And when a week without electricity, which just adds work to life, right? In addition to regular work and regular things that we have to do. And so we can't always dictate physical rest, but we can enjoy a depth of rest in our soul that is available to us in the person of Christ. And that is the rest that we read about here in Hebrews chapter 4, that we get to experience in the person of Christ. That Christ is our rest, our Sabbath. He talks about the fact that Joshua wasn't able to deliver them into this, right there in chapter 8. You know, the promised land didn't bring this rest. The promised land, there was, you know, of course, continuing of difficulties and challenges and battles. And so it wasn't there. It's in the person of Christ, this then future promise that they could look to. And for you and I as believers, he's then in verse 11 says, let us therefore strive to enter this rest. And at first glance, that sounds interesting because we associate strife with trouble, right? The idea there is just that we have a part in it, right? And our striving to enter this rest is really just drawing closer to Jesus, right? Let us therefore strive to enter the rest so that no one may fall short, right? Through disobedience, through lack of faith. And he goes on saying that the word of God is living and active, sharper than a two-edged sword, piercing to the division of soul and spirit and joints and marrow. In fact, to the finest parts of who we are, the deepest depths of who we are, the word of God goes there. And that's how we can experience in Christ this rest in our soul. Through God's word, we are reminded of the forgiveness found in the blood of Jesus Christ. The Bible says the blood is able to cleanse us. The blood of Christ is able to cleanse us from all sin. As we draw near to Christ and his word, we're reminded of that. The word of God counsels us. As we learn more of God's word, as we go to God's word looking for guidance and we understand biblical principles, we realize how we should respond to things. We realize the right course. Jesus, in fact, said he is the way. Right, as we draw closer to Jesus and we find our rest and our hope in him, he shows us the way. We find counsel. We find strength. We find life. Jesus said if we believe in him, fountains of living water, the idea of life-giving water, will flow from our soul. So I want to encourage you, this rest that we all appreciate and we all need is found in the person of Christ. in a personal relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. And I want to encourage you in just how much he loves you, and encourage you to draw near to him today through the Word of God. Take some time, you know, as Pastor John Corson often says, read your Bible and pray every single day. It's not because we're trying to earn favor with God by reading the Bible. It's because we get closer to God by reading the Bible. And as we get closer to the Lord, we enter more and more into his rest. So would you do that today? Enjoy the rest that is in Christ. He loves you and he's for you. God bless you.